Dear participants, we will now soon be beginning with the second session today. And as I have received some queries in the chat, that you will be at what time you can submit and you have not received your activity. So I want to clarify that each and every participant will receive the email on their registered email ID only. You have to check your email regularly for receiving the assignments in the email, as well as we are sharing in the group. Again and again we are sharing, so you can check the group also. Attempt it as soon as possible, but every day before 7 p.m. in the evening you can attempt. And it is mandatory to fill that activity forms, as the speaker or the resource person will take a closer look at your responses to judge your academic style. I will share again the assignments. You are free to attempt it till 7 p.m. today evening. Now I would like to invite the session planner of this session to start with the session.
Good afternoon to all. I would like to pay my thanks to our coordinator, Dr. Pankaj Madan and Dr. Suyu sir, for providing me an opportunity to be a session planner in ETL FTP. Now I would like to invite Dr. S. Ambu Prasad, serving as a principal and professor of mechanical engineering with 28 years of rich experience in Pragati Engineering College, Kakinada, and is acting as a chairperson in today's session. Now, sir, hand over to you.
Thank you, Ms. Ritu Rajan. Good afternoon to one and all. Respected Professor Pankaj Madan, Dean Faculty of Engineering and Technology, Coordinator of FDP, respected Dr. Suryash Bharadwaj, Co-Coordinator of FDP, and Honorable Speaker of Session, Professor Gunamal Suri, Organizing Team of FDP, Organizing Team Members of this session, Ms. Ritu Rajal, Ms. Gautami, Dr. Poonam, Dr. Deepika Bhatt, and eminent academicians and my fellow participants from various locations of the country, I extend a hearty welcome to one and all for this session. Now it is my pleasant duty to invite Ms. Gautami, research scholar in management studies, Gurukul Kangri Vishwavidyalay, for reciting Vedic mantra. Over to Ms. Gautami.
Thank you so much, sir. Am I audible, sir?
Yes, madam, you are audible. Please continue.
Thank you so much, sir, for giving me this opportunity to chant the Vedic mantra. The mantra is Pratidhyuta nama rushaso asvakshetra adrasrannusha sambahantaha yati subhra visva pisharathena dadhati ratna vidhateja nama. This mantra has taken from the Rig Veda Saptama Mandala of 7.75.6, which explain about the relevance with leadership. It is said that a woman with good qualities can also administer the nation by becoming a queen. According to the Rig Veda, the functions of the minister are as follows: to make the good arrangements of the subjects in the nation and to keep harmony with the thinkers of the king. Similarly, if a woman has the qualities for an administrator, she can be a leader of the organization. Thank you, sir. I would like to invite Dr. Sambhu Prasad, sir, for the discussion. Over to you, sir.
Thank you. Thank you, Ms. Gautami. Discussion question or thought for the day today is, for today's session, what are the qualities needed to be a woman leader? As a part of initiating the discussion, I am mentioning some of the women leaders of India, Rani Lakshmibai of Jhansi, Sarojini Naidu, Annie Besant, Aruna Asaf Ali, Kasturba Gandhi, Kamala Nehru, Vijayalakshmi Pandit, Savitribai Phule, Mother Teresa, Aruna Roy, Medha Patkar, Shaheen Mistry, Mrs. Indira Gandhi, our Prime Minister of former Prime Minister of India, and Mrs. Kiran Bedi, and yesterday's inaugural session chief guest, Professor Surekha Dangwal, Honorable VC of Dhoni University, and so many people in various responsible women leaders in various responsibilities. My opinion, women in the role of mother demonstrates the qualities of patience, hard work, affection, and she is a great motivator. The working women are playing several key roles in their respective fields of work. Now I invite the participants for discussion. So I request the participants to throw your to share your opinions on the discussion on the question for discussion. The question is, what are the qualities needed to be a woman leader? Let us make the session interactive. Please come forward. There are so many women participants here. I request the women participants to take lead.
You can unmute yourself.
Sir, this is Sarita. I think that women should have a good self-confidence, should be bold enough to handle the situations, and aware of all the things which are in and around her surroundings. So if you have a better view, I think that she can be a good leader.
Okay, thank you, Sarita madam.
So thank you.
Any other person, please come forward.
This is Dr. Padmuja speaking.
Yes, sir. Most welcome, madam. Please share your views.
Yeah, I had one of the premier institutes in Hyderabad. So this is called Keshav Memorial Institute of Technology, and I'm head of the Department of Computer Science and Engineering. During my headship, I see that I observe one thing which is very important for a woman leader, and that is patience. And any up and down, I mean, and women have that. I majority of women have that, and that's the reason why women are leading, are in the leading position. So I believe in that, and then followed by self-confidence and leadership role qualities, whatever she should have. These are the first come qualities which I wanted to put in front of you.
Thank you. Thank you, ma'am. So any other views?
Sir, I would like to say.
Please.
Supriya Jagtap.
Indra.
Supriya Jagtap from Maharashtra, Pune. Should I?
Yeah, please, madam. Please continue.
Yeah, I totally agree with your the sentence. As you can see, the women have their value, work-life balance. They are very great listeners. As already the madam has said, the women are having highly patience with them. They are quite nurturing. They focus totally on the teamwork. They are good listeners. Even they have a multitasking with them. They are always motivated with the challenges they faces, whatever they faces. And even they are a very strong communicators, what I think. Thank you.
Thank you, ma'am.
Sir, this is Dr. Minimal MC from Kerala.
Yeah, can I? Please, madam. Yeah, please, madam.
Sir, my concern is actually, can we actually classify the qualities required for women leaders and other leaders? Is it common, or how is it basically?
most some of them will be common, but the question asked for discussion is regarding what are the qualities of the women leaders.
For my who should not be sensitive and broad-minded, that should be a main quality to be a good leader.
Yeah.
Hello,
please, madam.
Yeah. As per my understanding, the women leadership, the main quality is the involvement, commitment, and patience. And these are come maybe by the situation and all. So this is the different feature. This is a different feature is in compared to the main. So this is the my side contribution.
Thank you.
Can I say something, sir?
Please, madam. Please.
I am Joita Shah from Kolkata International Institute of Hotel Management. I feel that a woman is a very special person, and we really cannot equate. I mean, there's a saying, men are from Mars and women are from Venus. That is very true. We cannot really, you know, a woman, a very successful woman, very often has to sacrifice a lot in terms of family life, you know, if they are busy in corporate leadership or so a woman has to act with a lot of intelligence. A very good example of this is a mission to Mangal Yatra. I don't remember the name of the film where Vidya Balan had worked, acted. You know, she was equally efficient at home and equally efficient at her work, and she used her intelligence to do her job effectively in both her arenas. I think that is an example of a woman leadership. I feel that is my personal opinion, sir.
Thank you. Thank you. Any other views?
Can I add something, sir?
Yeah, please.
Yeah, this is Deeksha, a research scholar from Faculty of Management Studies, Gurukul Kamri Deemed University. So I just want to add something about that, what exactly the qualities of a woman leader, which is different from the male leader. But a woman leader is very flexible in working with the persons which are involving in the team. And she should be very good in managing multitask, as she know about how to handle the homework, and she know that how to do a multitask in that. And she is very motivated to all the things. And what exactly the thing which we observe, that a woman should be a strong communicator. A woman should have come up with their strong ideas, strong communication with all the team members, so that the team members will be motivated for doing all the things very well. And the one thing which I add in this is also, she will be a big dreamer. Because if a woman is having a big dream, so she will be able to do task with very firmly and very effectively. So as we know, every woman is having that quality to take all the situations and to handle all the situations as they're having their practices at home. So it will be very effective in the organizations to achieve their goals and to achieve the success of the organization.
Okay. And I know that.
Sir, I'm Harika from Telangana state. Actually, as a woman, because I've been also a woman, I don't want to discourage any woman in the field, but they are very strong in doing all the activities. So I think it's like this, when and how we have to do the things. Thank you, sir.
Thank you. So I know that many of you are maybe further interested to share, but due to time constraint, I am trying to summarize the viewpoints expressed by the members and give my own viewpoints also. I thank Madam Harika and Dr. Padmaja and Dr. Supriya Jagtap and Dr. Minimal and Joita Shah and Madam Deeksha Ashuja and some others who have expressed their views. And some other key points, qualities they mentioned are self-confidence, good communication skills, they should have broad-mindedness, and they should have flexibility, and they should be big dreamers, etc., and they have good patience. These are the some qualities which are mentioned for the women to be good leaders. And in fact, being an administrator and from the research studies, my observation is when it comes to the productivity in organizations, women employees productivity is relatively better and their commitment is better. This is my own opinion and my own observation. I hope the male members in the forum will not differ this with this and try to accept this. And I have just referred to some of the research, and some of the qualities of the women leaders are they are more assertive and persuasive and more willing to take risks and more empathetic and flexible, and they are stronger in interpersonal skills, demonstrate an inclusive and team building leadership style of problem solving and decision making exists with them. The determination to turn challenges into opportunities is more. So with this summary, now I conclude the discussion on the question for the session. And now it is my pleasure to introduce session coordinator, Dr. Poonam. Dr. Poonam is working as assistant professor in Department of Management Studies, Kanya Gurukul campus, Gurukul Kangri Vishwavidyalaya, and having 22 years experience. Now I request Dr. Poonam to introduce speaker of this session, Professor Gunamala Suri, Professor of Punjab University, Chandigarh. Over to Dr. Poonam. Dr. Poonam, are you there?
Ma'am, you are not audible. Please speak a little bit louder.
Most welcome.
Thank you, Professor Sangu Prasad ji. Yes, sir. Am I audible? Yes, ma'am. You are audible now.
Yes, ma'am, you're audible.
Yes, am I audible? Audible. Yes, yes. Thank you so much, sir. I take second session, Dr. Gunamala Suri. Sure, after I introduce, you all will agree with me that her name is undermined. I mean, Divala means string of qualities. But when you doubt her synopsis, you will all agree with me. Not a string of qualities. She is a ma'am. Welcome you. I will first read out her achievement. That is so much in coincidence. Vedic mantra which said what are the qualities female leader. Okay, so me epitome, she's a greatest example. Said.
I think ma'am Poonam is not audible. Session planner, can you please read out and introduce, or session coordinator, can you please read out and introduce Professor Gunmala Suri? Even chairperson, I request chairperson, he can also do it, please.
Sir, yes. I will take that responsibility. It's my pleasure to, am I audible, sir? Can somebody?
Yeah, very much.
Yeah. Thank you.
Yes.
So it is my proud privilege to introduce today's session speaker, Dr. Gunmala Suri. Dr. Gunmala Suri, she is currently professor of Punjab University, Chandigarh, and she is having 25 years insightful experience in coaching, guest lectures, consulting, HR, research, writing, and chairing sessions in national and international conferences. She is having industry exposure in consulting, education, IT, medical equipments, agricultural technology. Her competencies are in the areas of strategic thinking, operations management, research, process and policy depth, management by objective, writing, conflict resolution, and flexibility. And her research interests are business process reengineering, total quality management, knowledge management for organizational effectives and e-learning. And she has received several awards, and like recipient of Devang Mehta National Education Award, Women in Education Leadership in December 2017. And she's visiting fellow Hungary University grants through UGC in 2010, Indo-Swiss Bilateral Program Fellowship 2007, and visiting fellow to University of Lausanne, Switzerland in 2005. And she's the recipient of Commonwealth Fellowship. And she got professional membership in various professional societies. And she's a board member in various board of studies, and BOS member. And she has published several books and several papers in international journals of repute. And it is really and indeed a great pleasure for me to introduce such an eminent academician to the all the participants in this gathering. And now I request madam to share your knowledge to all the participants. Namaskar, madam.
Thank you so much, Dr. Surapani. You have elaborated so much about me. The expectation is set so high. Dr. Pankaj Madan has given me the opportunity to share my views on the topic, how to have a best presentation and what are the skill set required for everyone to have a unique presentation. We all want to be a class one in the presentation skill, because in the pandemic, everyone is talking of the keyword skill. So we have to sharpen few skills. Out of that, I have tried to figure it out, a skill of presentation. So let's see how we all can do. I'll share my slides with you, and you can see the importance of each and every pointer. I hope you people are able to see the slides. It's in a presentation form.
Yes, madam. Yes, okay. Yes, ma'am.
Right. So we are having a chat box. I need some help for the, if I ask something, somebody will read it for me, what the participants are writing. I know you are already experienced. I have heard Padmaja and other ma'ams who are already working, so much of experience. You are principal somewhere, for heading the institution, heading the department. So many times you have done the presentation, but the quote says, learning never ends. There is always something to improve upon. I have heard in the morning, Dr. Karamjeet was saying, change is only the permanent. So what kind of a change you accept? That means you are in the path of learning. You are ready to accept what something good has happened and you want to imbibe. So I'll also try to figure it out and share with you the one of the HBR article which says the skills which are required to be in a best presentation. So I'll take a couple of minutes to go to the destination. Let's begin with my presentation will be in the form of three things. First, I will show a few videos. Then I have given you the activity. You people will be sharing the what kind of a presentation you have prepared. And in the end, the objective is to become a 0.01% improved version of the present, what the skill set you have. So the beginning is always good and it should be something different. As I have mentioned, the objective should be clear. The objective is essential thing to before every presentation. What do you know? You have the chat box. Can you write a couple of keywords? What do you do before presenting? Some secrets. Anyone who can, Dr. Bhardwaj, anyone can assist me for reading? I just can't read the chat box. Please write.
Yes.
What do you do?
Sure, ma'am. Sure, ma'am.
Please. Somebody has written contact details. Anybody else? Please write something so we have better idea. Aim.
Can I say something instead of writing please. Down?
Okay.
I'm Joita Shah again from Kolkata, International Institute of Hotel Management. Before presentation, I think it's very important to understand why we are making this presentation. Okay, what is the role that we are playing in making this presentation? And what do we want to achieve? Who is our audience? What do we want our audience to gain? What do we want to gain out of this presentation? I think these are the few questions that is very important to answer before we even start preparing, thinking of the content.
Okay, somebody has written content. Somebody is writing background. Have a big smile. Somebody is writing something on a big smile on their face. Target audience. Okay, fine. That's good. We have something in mind before starting, right? So I will, everything what you are saying is absolutely correct, but I have a little different way of demonstrating what you have said. So I am going to show a video. Can you see?
Yes, ma'am.
Okay, fine.
Audio is not.
कहाँ पर? इसमें बोलने का कुछ नहीं है, सिर्फ आपको देखना ही है. अगर कहाँ से share करना है? Sharing में है लिया क्या?
Ma'am, stop करिए एक बार sharing. दोबारा से जब share button पर click करेंगे. तो ऊपर ऑप्शन आएगा मैम शेयर फॉर मीडिया
स्टॉप शेयरिंग
अभी वीडियो का जो ऑडियो है वो नहीं आ रहा है शेयर बटन पर क्लिक करेंगे मैम जैसे ही विंडो दिखाई देगा आपको उसमें ऑप्शन आएगा शेयर फॉर मीडिया
Madam, otherwise in the top file, edit, share, the option under share, there is also an option. File.
So, what is the reaction?
Grammarly helps you do this. It helps you rewrite full sentences to improve clarity and help cut down on unnecessary words. It's a digital writing assistant that is used by 30 million people all around the internet, and I'm a big fan of Grammarly. With their help, you can expand your word selection and replace boring or bland words with more exciting, effective, and
yes, what is the reaction of seeing that video? Although audio was not there.
We have to be very clear when we are giving instructions.
Yes, yes, one thing. Any other thing, any other observation? I hope most of you have seen that video.
Can I add something, ma'am?
Yes, please.
Yes, we have to make sure specify all the characteristics or and all the things of that presentation. As we see, we just view up just front view of that this style, but we just not we just skip the back view of that style. So we have to show all the all the aspects of that particular topic which we are going to present in that presentation.
Yes,
so first
yes,
thing, yes. We have to learn all the things about that, deep study about that topic.
Absolutely, Deeksha. Absolutely, Deeksha. Your perception is absolutely correct. Whatever we are seeing, what we want, what is our expectation, and what we are delivering, everything should be explicit. So planning is the first thing. उसने प्लान तो कहा पर प्लान करने के बाद बाकी के क्या स्टेप्स हैं दे हैव नॉट फोकस्ड ऑन दैट सो दैट वीडियो क्लियरली डेमोंस्ट्रेट अबाउट दैट थिंग सो आई एम जस्ट ट्राइंग टू फिगर इट आउट व्हाट यू हैव सीन इन द वीडियो दिस इज द स्लाइड व्हिच इज एक्सप्लेनिंग अबाउट व्हिच फ्यू ऑफ आवर ऑडियंस हैव एक्सप्लेन्ड Who are the listeners? Are we going to talk to the managers? Are we going to talk to the employees? Are we going to talk to the CXOs? So everyone has got a different time slot. And what is the common ground? What big idea we are going to achieve? What is the objective of our presentation? After the presentation, are we going to attract the shareholders? Are we going to attract the angel investors? What is their need? Are they looking for the profitability of that particular project? Is this project, is my presentation, is going to answer all the questions? That presentation has the three pointers as this circle on the right-hand side of the slide is talking about. We have to create the connectivity with the people who are our audience. If CXO is there, he has very few minutes to understand. He is looking towards the end result. If we are talking to the employees, they would like to understand each and everything nitty-gritty in details. So there should be a story. Every presentation should have a story. If you have some background story, then the people are going to correlate. I'll tell you a beautiful story of Mahindra and Mahindra Resort. It is in the Coorg, and usually after 5 p.m., they don't entertain the guest. The process is Mahindra and Mahindra Resort is 60 kilometers away from the city. So people have to travel and they reach and all the area is secluded, or you can say a jungle area. But people usually call before coming. The time for the inn is the 5 p.m. They usually don't allow. One couple who were traveling from Bangalore. They called them around 3 o'clock, 3:50. We are coming from Bangalore to Coorg. We will be going to stay in Mahindra and Mahindra, and we are stuck in the traffic jam. We may be little late. That particular person who received the call on the reception conveyed this message to the dining hall that they people will be late, so please keep some dinner for them. It was around 6:30 or so, and the shift of that manager who is in charge of the dining hall has to change. New person has to come. Then he thought that if the people who have called us reached by 5 o'clock, not reached, how can they reach after 2 hours because it's a traffic jam? So what he did, he took some food, packed the food from the kitchen, and he was, while going back, he located through a phone call and delivered that tiffin or you packed eatables to them. So it was a story Mahindra and Mahindra Resort always share with the people whenever the investors come or whenever they have to attract the people, that this kind of a dedication is present in our employees. So you should have some kind of a story as like a Mahindra and Mahindra people have, or that particular chef or that particular employee of the Mahindra and Mahindra has shared, has depicted. Saying something and doing something is different. So presentation should have some story to engage the people, that the people can be interested in your presentation. This is part of it. The another thing, anyone can say something about the picture which you can see on your screens? Anyone? Unmute yourself. Picture is visible.
The Last Supper.
Right. Chavi, absolutely. Anything else? Picture is from Last Supper.
Ma'am, before the crucifixion, I'm not very well
okay, never mind. This. Never mind. Anybody else? We have
a fresco. It's a fresco drawn by Leonardo da Vinci.
Yes, it is a painting by Leonardo da Vinci. Absolutely. So one painting has different characteristics. The supper from the supper and the Leonardo da Vinci. Anything else? Leonardo da Vinci was an engineer as well as a painter. And anything else? Anybody else would like to say something? The painting is usually painted on the canvas, but this is on something special. 1914, this painting has been painted by Leonardo da Vinci on the wall. Usually, paintings are painted on the wall when the paint is wet and they try to finish it off. But he used a different way of painting. Why? Because he thought, I'm not going to finish that within the stipulated time because I have to do a minute or critical details with passage of time as and when I will feel like that. That is also the specialty of this painting. Anything else anybody would like to say? Very famous, the Last Supper. Something Jesus has also described, that somebody who is going to betray me out of my all followers. All the followers were sitting. He has not mentioned the name, but he has mentioned that somebody is going to betray me. So declaration by Jesus was done in this particular picture. Anything else important?
Which I remember very vaguely, it was something also to be done with the flesh and the blood. He said this milk is not milk, but it is the blood of the people which will be massacred. and the bread is the flesh of the flesh and blood. I just don't know the connect, but yes, there is something like this about mentioned in that about flesh and blood.
Means, yes. Absolutely, Poonam. Yes, you have said rightly. And the importance, or when I was just search on the Google, it says 14 different things which people don't know about this painting, but we usually see. So that is the secret why I have chosen this, because only one thing, Last Supper and the painting by Leonardo da Vinci. Who is Leonardo da Vinci? Who was an engineer by profession, but he has done painting. And in the end, he was near the king. When the king says you have to complete the painting, and due to some wound in his right hand, he has completed the painting with his left hand. So these are the different 14 things which I have read. And the another thing they were mentioning, what kind of a food they were served on the table. So one painting talks many things. Which
may I put some comments, ma'am?
Yes, please.
There is perspective in this painting.
Right. What kind of perspective you want to say?
We can see walls converging. Right. Side walls. This is the beauty of the painting. This is the best technical point in this.
Yeah, that is the Leonardo da Vinci perception. Or you can see he was not a painter, but he engineer converted to a painter. So he has also thought of new ways of doing the things. Absolutely. It's your observation, how we say something or how we perceive out of that. So that is what the presentation I prepare, and what you get out of that is maybe similar or may not be, but the best presentation should convey the same message. That is why I have put this particular kind of a picture. So people should get the same message, what is expected from this kind of a presentation. The different pointers which I have mentioned on bottom of this picture is also important. We vary, presentation varies. We also do this. The lifestyle of the people, we have seen the Myntra, the online portals which we are doing, which we are nowadays purchasing so much, Amazon. They are also giving you the presentation of the product. You want to purchase a dress, you want to purchase a merchandise, you want to purchase a grocery, you want to purchase anything out, household item, electronic item, laptops, or any other item. There is a presentation, and that presentation also varies from age, education, gender, ethnicity, your lifestyle. What we are getting in Punjab, a dress style, people in the South are having a different kind of a dress style, and Amazon is providing that kind of a search engines. They, you can say, making the algorithms that the people who are in the North, East, West get a different kind of a presentation of a different products. So presentation doesn't mean you are presenting in a class only or presenting to the students only. Presentation is a wider way to understand your audience, understand the personality, understand the social and cultural needs. According to that, you have to mold it. The product which Nykaa is providing you, the product which Google is providing you, the product which Apple is providing you, they are also having some kind of a presentation. Presentation doesn't mean it should be of 20 slides. It can be of 2 slides. And they should be able to convey that particular message, which I'm going to discuss when I am going to see the presentation of the audience, which you have been prepared as an assignment. Let me finish my thoughts. I'll share my thoughts, and then we'll switch over to that particular. The importance of this slide is the research. In the previous session, Dr. Amit was presenting about the leadership, and he mentioned that these articles I have written, and these articles are important. Whenever you get time, you can read. So similarly, when we are making the presentation, these kind of research are important. What the statistics is saying, we all are going through with the COVID wave, how the plateau is going, how many patients are there, how many hospitals are there, how the patients are taken care, everything is in a research value in the numbers. So we try to correlate for the audience. It's easy to correlate. When your small child at home wants a toy, you will say, if you do this, then I will do this. So you also research that he is motivated through this kind of a things. So that is also your research based information, maybe peer research, maybe your research, or maybe research by HBR. And everything you say or you present is supported by an research. You can also correlate with that IIT Kanpur has a portal which says which helps the farmers for the pesticides, for insecticides, and for the soil manures, how, when, where, how much you should add to the soil for the better yield. So they also do this kind of a research and provide them the data. Nowadays, all the farmers are connected through mobile network and they get the price all over India, the same price. So that is also the presentation of their yield, presentation of their particular product that helps them to grow and work faster. Before going again, I'll have the another important video which I would like to show. Before showing that video, some of our participants has said that we have to make an outline. How to make an outline? Like an architect. When the student go to an architecture college, he or she is not aware of many things. He knows how to draw something, but it is not essential. He is expert of all the things, but by understanding the science of architect, he is able to draw the pictures on the right-hand side of my screen. So on the simple lines, with the help of simple lines, they draw something magical. So how they do that magical work? That means they made something on their paper to have some a dramatic view. The another example which I would like to quote here, when we buy a house, or you can say nowadays builders are there, 3 BHK, 4 BHK, 2 BHK studio apartments, the space is the same, 1000 square feet, 1200 square feet, or whatever the square feet the space is. On that particular space, different architects or designers make such an arrangement of the rooms that they look spacious. So that means they are understanding the audience. Similarly, we also have to present our data or views that they look, they sound music to them. If something sounds music to the audience, definitely they would like to be glued to your presentation, to your product, to your system, whatever you say. Before going to this, I would like to show you one more video. Can you help me? Where should I put the sound? You can see I have shared the video.
You have to share the screen with media.
Madam, in top that file edit view share option is not there. Share with the multimedia option. Share which is in your
ma'am in Cisco when you share, click on share.
Right. Fir content and share with browser. Multimedia is not activated at my system.
Yes, yes, ma'am. Yes, ma'am.
How to activate?
On the top corner. On right, the top, yeah. See two options: share for text, share for media.
On my screen, where I have to
stop sharing first.
Acha, okay, stop sharing.
Now click on the share button.
Okay, share.
Before sharing, check the top corner. Top. The small window which pops up.
अच्छा okay optimized.
उसमें motion top पर लिखा है share for yes ma'am share for media share for text.
Oh it is saying install not now it is not installed. Audio driver is not installed in my system.
No problem ma'am share the link in the chat of that video I will share my screen from this side.
Okay, that's also a nice way. Just give me a minute.
Can you share the link of that video? I will present from this side.
WhatsApp कर दूँ क्या?
हाँ कर दीजिए मैम कर दीजिए.
मैंने कर दिया फर्स्ट वाला शेयर करिएगा अभी फिर सेकंड वाला बाद में फर्स्ट वाला
ठीक है मैम मंकी डांस
यस 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 सॉरी फॉर द ट्रबल
नो प्रॉब्लम मैम नो प्रॉब्लम
लेडीज एंड जेंटलमैन स्टीव Ladies and gentlemen, Steve Ballmer!
Come on! Get on! Get on! Come on! Get on!
Thank you so much. Yes, what is the reaction? आपने ये, this is the video of 2006 and it is still relevant of Microsoft. He is also presenting. What is your reaction on that? Are you with me?
Hello.
Yes. Yes. Yes, Ruchi.
Yeah, what I think and about
energetic. Yes, yes.
It's showing, yeah, Ruchi, yes, Ruchi, please. Ma'am. Namaste, ma'am. It's showing that power and excitement, I think, is something company is for the company related thing. So what I am thinking now, that he may think about this is big thing and that challenges he completed. So mm-hmm. that for this challenges he enjoying and think about ki, yeah, we have done very confidently. But now
yes,
I'm thinking
yes.
the more discussion I may think another thing also.
Absolutely, yeah. Absolutely. That is what I have shared. Few of our participant has written surprised, enthusiasm, feel relaxed when he acts something childlike, not really relevant to that, showing his excitement. He wants to grab the attention of the listener. Absolutely. Somebody has written happiest
yes, madam.
At the peak.
Yes, madam. Yes, madam. I agree completely, Ruchi Tripathi madam. Apart from that, he is actually celebrating his
success.
Yes.
He wants to show his belongingness to the organization and
yes,
he is presenting his case to the stakeholders, to the shareholders that you should invest. I love my company and it is going to be a profitable.
Yes, madam. Yes.
So thank if you. I say I am very good, you please call me at your college. I will deliver a best lecture. So nobody is going to listen unless and until I have to show, demonstrate. So this is the example of demonstration. Yes. Which he is telling everyone to the stakeholders of his company. So words are important, but your gesture, your body language is also important. So the way you present is also speaking aloud. So loud and clear. It is not always with the words. You should not mince with the words always. But action, body language is important. And this is the video which is still relevant. Yes. Yes, somebody, Hardita, you want to say something? Eureka moment, some of the participant has written. Awesome. Suresh Verma has written Eureka moment. Hardika, you want to say something? And Vani said success. Even he can replace Amitabh Bachchan. Dr. Lokesh is saying in the Davar Chaman Prash advertisement, absolutely so much energizing. It's 2006. Awesome towards the company, belongingness towards the company. So almost all you have understood the way of presenting. Although the title given in the YouTube was Monkey Dance, doesn't matter. But he is able to convey the message. That's most important. So similarly, we have to have that kind of a thing in our presentation. So let me share my presentation. Slide is visible.
Yes, ma'am, it is visible.
Okay, fine. Strong introduction. The presentation has the four parts as it is divided. You can divide it into fifth also. That may be a question answer session. It depends upon you. But mainly, the best corporates, they are having their presentation divided into four parts. First, they will start about the introduction of the organization, introduction about the issue which they are going to talk, something, some kind of key pointers after doing this. If we incorporate this, if we introduce this technology, if we want to change from manual to automation in the organization or in the industry, if we incorporate this new machine, so new technology, if we invest 10 crores in this, out of that, these are the three pointers, three key points which are beneficial for the organization. And after that, you, if you do previously, these five companies and these 10 organizations have implemented this particular machines and taken the benefit out of that, that ends with a story of real life, story which the employees can correlate, or story which you can say your CXO or the investors can correlate. If we are floating the share in the market, then you have to tell the story that after doing this, we will have this kind of a benefit. Your money will increase manifold, and which the others are looking for that. That comes the relevant research, or you can say tailor your language. The example I was just sharing with you, suppose there is an issue in the organization of the attendance or the absenteeism or whatever you can say. So it's a common. If we are dealing or other, your presentation is talking to the employees, then you have to mention about the technology which you are going to use, how they have to use the technology, what is the pro and cons, what kind of errors they can do, and if they incorporate, if they are present whole of the month, and these are the incentives they are going to get. But if the same kind of absenteeism or the attendance issue is there, you are going to present to the senior manager, senior management, then you have to tailor maybe your language or the data in such a way that we have invested this much of money in this, and out of that, the absenteeism has been decreased, people have been educated, they are quite regular, their productivity has been increased. So research should be relevant on the same topic. It depends upon the audience, or you can say you are dealing with an employee or you are dealing with a senior management. So your research information should be relevant. Research is important. Similarly, tailoring your language or words is also important, talking to the two different group of people on the same agenda. Next comes thinking of example of your audience. I think I have shared two examples with you. Similarly, there are many examples. I am talking, dealing with the corporates. They have their different kind of issue. When I talk to the employees, they have different kind of issue. Similarly, we have to correlate. We have to talk in their language, in their presentation. In the same organization, when the person comes outside from the organization and he wants to motivate people, people think that they are going, he or she is going to tell something new. But the person who is inside the organization, suppose HR, they are going to tell with the presentation that these are the things important for the organization, people take for granted. So that is why the consultants are there, and consultants are very particular about the audience likes and dislikes. So what likes and dislikes are mentioned in the presentation, that makes the adaptability. Any question, please? Anybody would like to say something? So that is the reason why I have put this slide. If something is The another thing which comes to my mind, if I am presenting something in Hyderabad, there should be some, what are the important monuments over there? If we can correlate with them, or if we are presenting in Punjab, what are the important monuments over there? If we correlate them, that makes our presentation much more appealing or correlating the audience better. If I talk Charminar, the Hyderabad people will try to correlate quickly. If I talk of a golden temple, people of North will take up fast to correlate the things, the dresses and the similarly the other activities which we are presenting. Usually we know this, but sometime we forget all these small things. If the professor of history or geography, they are good in their regions, and I have heard their presentation, they try to link the history of that particular region to the present scenario and try to correlate the things, and that makes audience glued to their views. So that is also one of the interesting point learning. This is my learning out of my observing people of different domains. So different domain people have a different kind of a skill. All the management people are not expert in everything. So taking to you, to Albert Herbert, he says the best preparation for the good work tomorrow is to do good work today. How beautifully we have collected the data, how beautifully we have researched, how thoughtfully we have rehearsed that particular thing, then your presentation will be best. I know people, they are rehearsing in front of the mirror before delivering the final presentation to the CXOs. I know people in the industry, they are very good performers, but they are so well rehearsed of their presentation. They will give only 8 to 10 minutes presentation, but so crisp and clear because they have rehearsed so much on the pointers, which they pointed. Or the another best part, which I have come across a few days back, is the podcast. If you want to make a presentation on some topic and you find some podcast on that, so that podcast will help you so much that you can fine tune your words in such a way that they will flow like a water. And when your words flow like a water, your presentation makes so effective that people will love to listen to you. Although I will not say he or she is saying everything new in the podcast, but podcast way of presenting the information is little of higher standard, and we should listen to a good podcast. I'm not saying for every, but couple of podcasts are really interesting and educating. The next thing comes a balance. Data is important. Drafts are important. I know you people have prepared the slides, one or two slides on the topic. I'm going to understand how balanced you have taken between the analytical and emotional. When you are presenting, sharing your skills, just talk about one or two lines on this aspect also. What analytic aspect you have taken in the presentation, and what emotional things? Because analytical don't last longer as compared to emotional. That I have shown you in the video, that monkey man, he is so passionate about the Microsoft, he is emotionally telling you that I am associated with that. So creating a rapport with the audience, the emotional data is also important. If you want, I can explain a couple of examples. Let me go to the next slide. Because of the time, let me finish the things. Then if you want, I will come back to some of the things and explain them better with some more examples. And my mostly examples will be from industry because I am closely related with the industry, working so much of consultancy with them, evolving with them their issues which day to day are coming, and we are trying to resolve. Maybe it's related to employees or maybe finance or anything. So that will give your understanding about the industry much more better. Then it comes to remember few things we have to present, few things you have to remember on back of your mind. Something like that, we have not said any of the student, or it is not written any of the billboards in the school or the notice board. Nobody can come to the school or the college or the university in the swimming suit. But no one's coming in the swimming suit. We have not seen anyone sitting in the swimming suit in the class. Why? Because few things we remember on back of my mind. So these are the also things which you have to remember. Some shocking statistics should be there, some numbers which you can say. These are the shocking things. How much COVID is increasing? Oh my God, this is the peak. So some shock is there. Then visual, some visual graphs we usually have in our presentations. Then we have to demonstrate by memorizing that particular data and with the emotions. So these are the things which you have to remember on back of your mind while presenting. So I have used the crayons. Crayons are there. We love from the childhood if the crayons are given. The few sketches we make, everyone is not a painter or a best designer to make a drawing. But when the crayons are there, we like to scribble and we want to make something, our creativity, we like that. People appreciate or not, but it is there. Everyone has got this kind of a psychological thinking. So that psychological thinking we have to nurture, and nurturing that, then we can empathize with the audience. Then comes my favorite Walt Disney quote comes, at our studio, we don't write our stories, we draw them. Anybody can say something because it's quite near, it's quite close to the heart of most of the people. Walt Disney, we all know, we have grown reading about that and different stories of Walt Disney. People would like to go. Some people think that we will go. Few people have visited that Walt Disney Museum. Anybody would like to share anything about that? You're welcome to that. Anyone?
I have visited the Disney World in Florida and with my children. Mm-hmm. I don't know how much they could associate, but I was my younger self when I visited there. All these characters that we've grown up with, to see them so beautifully done in front of you, it was a pleasurable trip. I'll always remember.
Yes, so is this quote Wells correct or not?
Yes, definitely.
Definitely. So that means you have experienced, right?
Yes, so on the TV as well. Yes.
Yes. On the TV shows, we have on the TV shows and different TV serials are there. Most of the people have seen the things. So they say we try to draw them, not write the stories. So these are the two different things. Your presentation also make person think about that I am presenting on the Microsoft and you are as an investor. You have come here. I am so passionate that I am doing this much of work. My organization is doing this much. So you must invest in Microsoft. This is, I'm just giving, trying to correlate with the video which I have shown. So that is the in-depth way of presentation. So I'm sharing a couple of tips all the tips cannot be present in one of the presentation, but you can pick and choose and make your presentation live. So if you want to make the things live, you have to do things in a different way. So this is one of them. The another one is also quite correlatable. We are every day purchasing from Amazon, Nykaa, Google, or any other website. E-commerce websites are there, and they are talking about call to action. Call to action means free shipping. I want to buy some shirt from some jogging track suit. So they say, if you purchase from 5,000 and above, 2,000 and above, no shipping charges. Or if you sign up 30 days free trial for any course, if I want to do from Coursera or LinkedIn Learning and something like this. So they do a presentation to attract me that I should do a course from LinkedIn Learning, Coursera, or any other platform, and they allow me 30 days free trial. So this is call of action. Or money back guarantee. If you won't get the placement, something like that, yeah, after doing this, we will return your money. Or if you are not satisfied with your product which you are purchasing, 30 days money back guarantee. So these are the call to action. So call to action is also very important. When we are presenting in a class, it is some questions we are having for the discussion. This is also call to action. So call to action is a must thing, and it is in the trend. Previously it was not in the trend, but now we are having that call to action is in thing. Next comes think like a designer. What designer do? He is having a plain paper and a pen and some pencils or colors, and he designs something so beautifully that people will love. So designer, painter, or innovator, or what you say, think differently. So you have to start from the scratch. What kind of a scratch? You are going to build a building, create, that means plain slides, and on that you have to show your creativity. If you have creativity, or if you have the same particular boundary and you have written, you can say Time Roman 12 font words in your slide, you will feel yourself monotonous. So make your presentation like a designer. Limit your text. Your slides should not be full of words, full of paragraphs. I know you know many things. I know you know so many things about the Disney World. I know you know many things about the Leonardo da Vinci. But writing everything on a slide makes people offended, and they eat to your eyes. Sorry, they will not like to stick to your slides. Write as small as possible, as minimum text as possible. It can be colorful, or it can be black and white. It depends upon your thought process, or how designer you are. So that is why I have mentioned, think like a designer. If anyone has some views, they can unmute themselves and share something if you like. So complimenting what I have said, think like a designer. This picture was nowadays on the WhatsApp. I have picked it up from there just to share with you. Can anyone say something on this picture? Anyone?
The noodles are knitted, as in they're showing that the noodles in the soup are
Yes, yes, absolutely. It was a cartoon, something like, if you take your grandma to a Chinese shop or Chinese restaurant, what she will do? She will do the noodles and start knitting with them. So think like a designer. Your granny doesn't like noodles. Even my mom, she is 85. She doesn't like noodles and pizza and burgers. So if you provide, if you give them something like that, and her creativity will come, she can do, I can do knitting, I can do crochet and stuff like that. So you can also do something different. Your generation means, or younger generation, even my kids will never do. They don't know how to knit, but they like to eat noodles. But the generation of my mother or the grandma, she will start playing with that noodles. See, I can do anything. So that is why I have mentioned you in the previous slide, that think like a designer. The granny goes to a Chinese restaurant, think like a designer, and she'll knit noodles in such a way. On the lighter side of the story, although a lot of heavy stuff is coming, so I thought, let me put some humor. Okay. Visual presentation and some glitches. It is quite common. Even the Microsoft is not the exceptional. For that, you have to ready for that. Dr. Bhardwaj, can you show me the next video? The last one, the Microsoft one.
So yes, ma'am.
Yes, please. Ma'am. Can you please? Should I stop? So you people will enjoy how the Microsoft Poba has come. Are you there? I'm not listening to anyone. Can you write something? Yes, yes, in the chat box. So I
just plug it in. It's going to say, hey, I see you're plugged in a new device. And it's going to load in the appropriate drivers. You'll notice that this scanner build, whoa. Moving right along.
That must be why we're not shipping Windows 98 yet.
Absolutely. Let's plug it in. It's going to say, hey, I see you've plugged in a new device. And it's going to load in the appropriate drivers. You'll notice that this scanner build, whoa. Moving right along.
That must be why we're not shipping Windows 98.
Absolutely.
Thank you so much, Dr. Bhardwaj. This is the where the Microsoft people has also failed in their presentation. So anything can happen, and they have taken it quite supportively, positively, that this has happened. So you should have the humor of holding your glitches, because things are not in your control. You know your words, you know you cannot mince the words, you can play with your words, you can prepare your presentation, but on the end, when you are presenting it, presentation doesn't work. Or when they are just installing, they are showing the scanners which Microsoft can hold or Microsoft can connect, and that the glitch has come. So with that glitch, you should know how to handle that. So coming back to my presentation. That is what I want to share with you. Some kind of a glitches can come, unavoidable. You can say it is unavoidable things. Never mind. Then what are the advantages? Few advantages are there. It should be simple charts you can use. it should not be so complicated that people are so much engrossed or say they are so busy in that jigsaw that they're not able to understand what kind of a message you want to convey to them. For that, two things are important. Use that thing that is making an impact. How can you pick up that point? So it should be aligned with the goals of the presentation. Then add some credibility that you have done this kind of a research, and after that, these are the output of that research that which I am going to share. So if you do some visual charts in your presentation, although I have not used the visual charts because these are not relevant to me, how many people, if I communicate, I have come across a study of HBR. They are saying if you communicate with WhatsApp, if you communicate with email, if you communicate by calls or other media, social media, which is the best way to communicate with the audience or participant. So it comes out that email is the best way to communicate with the participant. So that is the best thing. The Dr. Bhadwaj is also sending everything through email so that you can be updated about the assignments, about activities, whatever the things are there. Similarly, in the organizations also, they also prefer an email for the update of the information, for scheduling the meetings or for any other activity which is happening to the organization. Next comes your modulating the voice. The second video which you have seen of Microsoft, how beautifully Ballmer has modified his voice, and in the end he just showed like he's a chairman or cheer girl's way. He was jumping here and there and shouting just to show this enthusiasm. And you have mentioned all these characteristics which he has shown in the Microsoft starting of the meeting. So similarly, modulating of voice is also important. As in the previous, in the Microsoft, he was also said that how the error has come. He has mildly said, okay, you have put it eventually and it has occurred. You have said the things in a certain way, subtle way, that is not being offended to it, but happened. Because in the audience, you have to understand that people are listening to you, they are understanding, they are waiting that your scanner is going to be compatible and you are showing the live, and the live has come the glitches. So on that glitch, you have to modulate your voice. Instead of being aggressive, modulated the voice and communicated that we can understand these kind of glitches are there and we have to abide, we have to embrace that, you can say, we have to embrace that. The another golden rule of presentation: never take that kind of a topic, or do not incorporate at that kind of a presentation which you won't want to sit through. It should be live, it should not be dead. When you are not enjoying, how your audience can enjoy, you have to live through. जैसे कहते हैं कि बच्चा जो है वो बचपन से लेकर बड़ा होता है तो वो उसको उस चीज को एंजॉय करता है, तो अगर वो एंजॉय करता है तो वो ग्रो फास्ट करता है. सिमिलरली द प्रेजेंटेशन इज आल्सो लाइक दैट, इट फास्ट फॉरवर्ड द वे यू एंजॉय इट. इफ इट इज ओनली फुल ऑफ वर्ड्स, लॉट ऑफ जार्गन्स ऑन द स्लाइड, इट इज मोनोटोनस, ओनली ब्लैक एंड व्हाइट और ऑल द बिग वर्ड्स, देन इट will eat to your eyes and you will not enjoy it. When you will not enjoy, you will think, oh, as soon as it will be completed, I will be free. So if that kind of a feeling is coming, so delivery is also important. So keep in mind what the motto at Duran Inc has said, Golden rule, never deliver a presentation you won't want to sit through. That is also, I just want to share, because you are going to be a best presenter, although you are, but what kind of a fine-tuning you are going to do has to incorporate, because some research scholars are also there. Research scholar to the senior people. Senior people have a different kind of a skill set, and they present the things in a subtle way. And that subtle comes to the research scholar when they reach that particular kind of a stage. So that comes to what is in your mind, what is in your slide, and what is you presenting on the camera. These are the three things. You have a number of words and number of things and number of experience, but you cannot express, you cannot correlate, you cannot tell each and every life story in one presentation. So you have to coordinate and put the three things: heart, your thoughts, your mind, your slides, and your camera. All the three things should be in a line. So that is why the purpose of this slide is always jot down the points which you want to highlight and put it them in a slide, not in the form of text, not in the form of so much of graphs. And when you are in the camera, few things be with you, not everything written on the slide, because when the slide is full of words, people are not going to listen to you. When they are listening to you, they cannot focus on the slide. It is a human psychology. The human psychology says, write less words and speak more. So when you have words, when you have research properly, then only you are able to speak. When you are able to speak, no need to put all the paragraphs, all the stuff which you know on the slides. So brain is sharp. Brain can manipulate faster than you. And when the brain is giving you next, put the pointers on the slide and try to be an interactive so that people should enjoy. This is the fantastic thing which I have come across recently. I have done a training for train the trainers. And that training trained the trainers from Bosch. So I'm a certified Bosch trainer. And that, from that training, I picked up this slide. And they say, test the equipment, bring the backup, test your deck. Although we do that, but the way they have presented this slide, I really like that. Although we are doing all these things, we try to test our laptop, we try to go through our slides, but there are some glitches, which is unavoidable. Just now, I am not able to play the audio, so I have requested Dr. Bhadwaj to play my video on his system. So, anticipating all these glitches, you should have a plan B. I can WhatsApp him my video and he's able to show you. So end result is final. End result is good. You people are able to enjoy the videos. I hope you enjoyed. That is my perception. I tried to do my level best to you people so that the tech glitches can be avoided. Now this is my last slide. And then we will be discussing about your preparation, which I have given five different topics, and you have to prepare one and two slides. This is simple and normal for everyone. If you are nervous, then take a deep breath. I remember when I joined the university, I worked in industry 10 years. And after doing my industry, I joined the academia, and I have no experience talking to the students. I was sitting on chair and table and doing all my file work and things like that. I have done many projects, but talking to students standing on the podium was challenging. I was so much terrified. I don't know how to speak. 1 hour and 15 minutes I have to speak, although the material I know, but facing the student was a challenge once upon a time. So this slide is why I have kept it in the last, because I have also felt like that, talking to the audience is also quite a nervous thing. So these are the things for my novice friends, those who have now. In my time, there were no presentation tools were there. We were having overhead projectors. We have to write the things on overhead projector sheets. On the night, I prepare my sheets. And in the morning, I have to take it and put it on the overhead projector. And then I have to explain to the student. Fortunately or unfortunately, I'm a person of quantitative, so I cannot write everything on the slide. I have to solve the questions on the blackboard. So I try to mix and match the things. I was very nervous that time. Now the time has passed. There are not much issued. And the students are much more smarter than us from the class 8th, 9th, 10th. They know how to do a presentation. They know how to prepare a PPT. And they all work in Microsoft tools. And they are well-versed with all these stuff. So that is all from my side, Dr. Bhadwaj. If the people can share their presentation, then I can discuss on them. I have tried to finish my side.
Sure, ma'am. Participants, if you are willing, you want to share your screen, you can.
At least 10-15 participants should share one by one so that we can have a fair view of their thought process, how they have presented the things, the topic given to them. I have also shared one link of TED Talk. Whenever you get time, you can also go through that TED Talk that is also explaining a couple of tips, how to have a class presentation and how to improve your presentation, or tips, you can say whatever you want to say. How can you improve yourself this kind of a skill? I hope you enjoyed that, and we'll do the now presentation part of your assignment.
Ma'am, we received 126 submissions from participants. We have
awesome.
Yes, we have a very active participants we have in this FDP. And I hope anyone of you can share your screen to show the slides which you have submitted in the assignment.
Yes, anyone should volunteer. We have around 20 or you can say 15 minutes. In 15 minutes, we can have one minute, 15 participants can do the work, depending upon their willingness.
Madam, you are asking about the cryptocurrency, madam. This is
yes, here. Yes, anything cryptocurrency. Yeah, I have cryptocurrency. Given five topics, Sanji. Yes.
Yeah. Okay, I will try to share that. We will discuss on that.
Growth mindset, urban forestry.
Yeah, and also cryptocurrency.
Yes, please. Because I don't know about the interest, that is why I have given the versatile topics that anyone can write and anyone can think of. So people who are from IT, they would love to have cryptocurrency. Otherwise, exactly. Growth mindset. Yes.
Yeah, it's opening now. I'll just try to share it.
Dr. Vijay.
Yeah. So it's just a two slides.
Yes, I told you one or two slides. So that
just one or two slides.
So I think Mamta Thakur has shared something.
Doesn't matter. Just first Mamta Thakur can share, then next Dr. Vijay can do it.
Yeah, correct.
Okay. Ma'am, I have done a 2-slide PPT.
Yes, ma'am.
Urban forestry.
Yes, please.
Yes, ma'am. So, as time was little less, so we made only a little bit of content.
Okay, and just I remember think about it. That is the beauty. I also mentioned write less and speak more.
Yes. As I remember, we have to follow a 15-line concept while making PPT. So using that, I'm new to the Cisco WebEx. Please give me a little bit of time.
Okay, no problem.
And I have logged in using 2 devices.
I have also mentioned the technical glitches. So it's common for everyone. No worries. We all are novice. We all are same.
So here, urban forestry, what do we mean by it? An urban forestry is the care and the management of the single trees and tree population in urban settings. Basically, we are lacking the facility of plants and trees in urban areas. So we need to work on this, think about this. So we have to focus more on urban forestry. And what are the advantages of it? We have to reduce the environmental pollution, and we have to recreate and improving aesthetic values of the place around where we are living. Only That's these right. two have prepared, ma'am.
Beautiful.
Can I stop sharing?
Your background is good. You have taken forest to the your home. The objective of this is like that. We have to take the forest to our homes, or nowadays all the multi-story buildings are coming and people have no space for the plants. So there should be allocated place for that plants so they can breathe in, and good for the atmosphere and good for your health. That is the objective. Okay, good, ma'am. That's good.
Thank you, ma'am.
You have prepared nicely. The next. Dr. Vijay, you can share.
That is, yeah, can you see the screen? Cryptocurrency?
Yes.
Can you see the screen, madam?
Ab to nahi dikh raha.
But it is.
Share again, Vijay sir. Share again.
Yes. Yeah, I am just opening it again.
Okay. IV saying I cannot present, ma'am. My mic is not working. Never mind. Or kisi ka jiska mic chal raha hai, they can do. And somebody is writing. Mr. Anil is writing something.
But I can discuss on what is the thing that I have written in the cryptocurrency.
Point here is my topic is presentation. So presentation skills.
Yeah.
Okay, you can talk. Never mind. Anybody else can try by the time.
Yeah, I have a poor
connection. My share option is disabled. Deeksha is saying.
Yeah.
Ma'am, now it's enabled. Can I present my PPT?
Yes, you can present by the time you're presenting.
Ma'am, is my presentation seen? This is Nishant here.
छा तो रहा है आई डोंट नो किसका है ये चल रहा है
दीक्षा इज शेयरिंग निशांत सर प्लीज वेट
यस सर
दिस इज डॉक्टर दीक्षा शर्मा मैम फ्रॉम नेशनल पीजी कॉलेज लखनऊ आई होप माय प्रेजेंटेशन इज विजिबल
यस यस
Okay, ma'am, since you asked us to prepare a PPT on cryptocurrency, so I took one of the cryptocurrency which everybody is discussing about these days, which is Dogecoin. So I prepared a PPT on this. I am an assistant professor in the Department of Banking and Finance at National PG College, Lucknow.
Great.
Basically, what it is said that, you know, jokingly, it is always said that ek tweet ki keemat tum kya jaano Ramesh Babu. It's so this basically means that due to one tweet of Elon Musk, the price of Dogecoin raised. And yesterday, this screenshot I took yesterday of the price of how much a Bitcoin actually costs. And the answer was that it costs around 32 lakhs. In the INR currency, and if you can see, days before the currency was somewhere around 45 lakh, and the price dropped from 45 lakhs to 32 lakhs because of the tweet that Elon Musk did. Now, I'll not take a lot of time. These are some of the screenshots that I took from Elon Musk's Twitter page, and what I perceive, I may be wrong, that what I perceive is that it could be that Elon Musk maybe has vested interest in Dogecoin, and that is why he's selling it, you know, he's promoting it or he's marketing this cryptocurrency. And I'd like to go further, just give me a minute. Yes. So just to brief or sum up my presentation, we have various types of cryptocurrency. One of the most famous one is Bitcoin, of course, or Dogecoin, or Bitcoin is called the king of all cryptocurrencies. And this cryptocurrency was basically invented by a person called Satoshi Nakamoto, a Japanese person. He is the first person to have created the cryptocurrency which we know as Bitcoin. Thank you, ma'am. That is the end of my presentation.
Great, Diksha. You have done nicely. You have talked about little about history, what is the present. You have used the graph. You have taken the screenshot from the Elon Musk or what is the current happening. And that is what is required in a good presentation. Maybe 2-3 slides can say whatever your thought process. It doesn't require 100 slides or 50 slides. It depends. The time given to you is only 2 minutes or 2-3 slides. So you have presented nicely and try to sum up the things. Excellent. Next, please.
Thank you.
That is what is needed.
Nishant sir, your screen is visible. Kindly open your presentation and rotate your mobile phone.
Am I audible?
Yes, yes, absolutely.
Yeah, one minute, ma'am. I'll just open my.
Visible.
Is the presentation visible, ma'am?
Yes, presentation is visible.
Okay, ma'am. So I had made a presentation about the growth mindset. So I had just kept students in mind as my audience. So in that way, I had made it. So I had here, I'm talking about what is a fixed mindset and what is a growth mindset. So I just shown as example. So usually students have this problem of not they think any task given, they feel very, they have a negative emotion. Okay, I cannot do this task or I cannot score well. So basis on that, here I had shown two perspectives. One is a fixed mindset and what is the growth mindset. So here to the right of the presentation, like I have shown like what are the points like a student should have. Like he should have a growth mindset. He must have a confidence that he can learn from anything he wants. And he can also, he should always take criticism in a very constructive manner rather than taking in a negative way. And a student should understand that any mistakes he makes is a learning curve for him. So he should consider those mistakes are valuable. Okay. But the same perspective we are going to take from a fixed mindset, he will consider that intelligence is all fixed. It is all inborn. It cannot be, developed. And he takes the criticism quite negatively, okay? And in the second slide, I have shown as an example, like what are the 5 points which are the steps of growth for a growth mindset? And I'd also put a statement from Carl Dweck, who's a researcher in this growth mindset. And what are the 5 points I say is like, always praise your effort and not the talent. And for example, here I have taken a case study like a student who is actually trying to improve his maths. The first thing is he will praise himself by saying, I'm solving at least problems for 15 minutes every day. So that is the first step. Second step is using the word yet. So here I have given an example where he could tell himself, I am not yet good at maths, but there is a chance that he will become good at maths. Okay. And then any challenges and are there to be taken as opportunities. So every time, so when a student gets a worksheet, he will say, ah, this is easy. But if I had, if I study well, if I give 10 minutes of dedication to it, I can easily score an A in that assignment. Okay, ma'am. And then enjoy the journey, not the end result. So he can keep telling himself that, yes, I will do better. Maybe I'm not getting what I'm the effort I'm putting. But yes, one day I will any always, if I keep on giving a little bit of focus and dedication, I can improve. And the last is to acknowledge and embrace the imperfections. So like the point which I have put here is the efforts which I have given earlier had made me score so much. So if I pour little more efforts, I can go to a bit higher level. That's what I have in my presentation, ma'am.
Great. Brilliant. Absolutely growth mindset. Those who will read this, definitely they'll become a part of the growth mindset.
Yes, ma'am.
You are able to convey the message which is required. Right, absolutely. Next, please. Anybody else would like to share or should I close the session?
Yes. Good afternoon, ma'am. Can I share my screen?
Yes, please. Yes, Deeksha, and this is the last. Dr. Bhada, this is the last because we have to wind up around 2.
Yes, ma'am. We can take more.
But this is the last. Yes, Deeksha, you can share the screen. Awesome. What a picture you have chosen. Here comes the thought process. How you can think.
Yes, this is the way I just want to present my slides for the growth mindset. The picture which... saying the words of the growth mindset, the how the roots of a plant is growing in our minds. So if we are having a growth mindset, then we are able to learn lot many things. And regarding to learning the new things, new concepts, rather than the fixed concept which we are just seeking in our mind to not to deal with the new things, not to accept the challenges. So in this way, I just want to add something which is related to that. How what are the types of mindsets are there? So we are having, there are two types of mindsets are there. Growth mindset, sorry. Growth mindset and fixed mindsets. And this, what are the exactly basic difference between that and how this is helping the leader should work for that. So what a fixed mindset is there, these are the challenges. They avoid the challenges. They do not accept the challenges and they do not want to work with new things. But if we are having a growth mindset, we will embrace the challenges. And persist in the face of setbacks. Okay, so what exactly it is there in growth mindset? We will just grabbing the opportunities to work with the new things. So the with this help of this chart, this given by the Cardell S. Dweck. He is a PhD and working in that. He's just giving us this chart. Through this, we are able to understand very clearly that fixed mindset people are avoiding challenges, obstacles, and efforts, criticism, success of others. They feel that they do not want to work for that. But if they are having a growth mindset, they will find that lessons for learning and inspiration of success for others. And they just want to learn from the criticism which we are just getting from the things which we are just trying to do it new. So the quote which is behind that is, Don't worry about failure. Worry about the chances you miss when you don't even try. This is given by Sermon Fensilver. So it's all about my presentation. Thank you, ma'am.
Good, good, Diksha. Growth mindset means we are always challenging ourselves and looking for the alternatives. Whatever the obstacles which are coming on our way, but we are looking something new, we think that we can do it. Not exactly what we are doing present, but we can do in a different way. So that is known as growth mindset. Over to you, Dr. Bhadwaj.
Thank you, ma'am. I will now call the session planner to conclude the session.
Thank you so much, ma'am. And I would like once again, you know, it was my, I missed the opportunity due to this technical glitch of introducing you. It was my loss. I once again, you know, would like to tell my audience, and I'm sure that all of them will agree that your name is very is defining you very less. Instead of a gun mala, that means a string of qualities. Aap gunon ki khan hai, madam. You are the mine of qualities. Beautifully done. Thank you so much. And now I invite Dr. Deepika Bhatt, our rapporteur for this session, to present the report. Once again, thank you, ma'am.
Welcome.
Can I audible? Hello, ma'am. Yes. Am I audible?
Yes.
Okay. Hello. Ma'am, am
yes,
I audible?
Yes, ma'am, you are audible.
Okay.
Yes, sir. Deepika, you are audible.
To all. Okay, ma'am. Good afternoon to all. Myself, Dr. Deepika Bhatt, Assistant Professor, HBMPG College, Raisi Haridwar. First, I would like to give my heartiest thanks to coordinator, Dr. Pankaj Madan sir, and co-coordinator, Dr. Suyas Bharadwaj sir, for giving me this opportunity and the report. Professor Unmala Suri has delivered her lecture on the topic Deliver Effective Presentation. She has considered planning as a very first step for presentation. Throughout her slides, she has explained that how can we make our presentation effective and interesting through the examples of stories, knowledge about behavior of audience, work on the time limit, evocative visuals, limited text, deep and clear imagination, and creativity for preparing presentation. She has also emphasized on the ideal way of presentation, that is, we should use strong introduction, 3 to 5 keywords, strong data, and ending with quote or story. She has discussed that our research should have relevant information, and we should have used clear and effective method of communication. She has deeply explained advantages of visual charts, modulation of voice, and rehearsal of material. The expert has also advised us that we can take deep and laugh before our speech to reduce our nervousness. At last, I would like to say that she has discussed each and every topic deeply and in a candid manner. So I thank Professor Gunmala Suri, ma'am, for this wonderful session. I hope you all will enjoy this session. And now I would like to welcome our chairperson, Dr. Surpani Sambhuprasad. Over to you, sir.
Thanks to Dr. Madan also. That will be important to mention. Although I'm not able to interact, but thank you so much, Dr. Madan, for giving me the opportunity.
Namaskar, madam. Thank you, Dr. Deepika Bhatt.
This is a very delightful, effective and information session from Professor Gunamala Suri. Thank you, Madam. Namaskar. And all the participants, I'm very sure that they are benefited. And the participants also played very active role by presenting some of the presentations they made and gave effective presentation. And this is one area where we need to continuously practice to reach higher levels. And I'm very sure that the inputs given by Professor Gunamala Madam will be definitely useful for the participant. On behalf of all the participants, I take this opportunity to thank Madam for a wonderful session. Thank you. Namaskar.
Thank you so much. Thank you, Dr. Sir.
I also take this opportunity to thank all the organizers for providing me this opportunity. It's a really wonderful idea from the organizers for involving the participants in the session proceedings. So really, it is a very, very wonderful idea, sir, thinking out of box. So for that, I congratulate the
program coordinator, Dr.
Pradhan.
Thank you, Dr. Madan, sir. It's for participants. The whole program is for participants. Thank you very much.
Namaskar.
Absolutely. Thank you so much.
Now I invite Ritu Rajan for announcements, if any.
Thank you, madam, for such a wonderful and informative session and for the active participation of all the participants. Now we can take off for lunch and let's meet again at 3 p.m. for third session. Thank you, madam.
Bye, everyone.
Thank you.